Greetings to all of my friends that have tuned into this broadcast today. Thank you so much for listening. I want to say hello to all my friends in Uganda and Kenya and Gambia. Also, I'm hearing from people all over the world, and I just mentioned a few of them, and I'm sure glad to hear from you. I get a lot of telephone calls from some of you overseas, and I haven't been able to return those calls, so that the demand is kind of heavy. And I appreciate all of my friends and family that are listening to this broadcast today. And I want to share to you a great scripture today, or a great chapter, I should say. And this is found in Acts chapter 27, one of the great chapters, I think, in the Bible, one of my favorites. I want to talk about three great anchors. And those anchors I'll mention in a little bit, but I want to tell you an anchor is something, it's a large piece of metal, and it's attached to a ship, and it when they let that anchor down, it will stabilize the boat and cause it to be steady, and that's what an anchor is. And I want to talk to you about some of those anchors today. The Apostle Paul was a prisoner, and he was on a ship headed for Rome. It is here where he will spend his last days. While they were on their way, Paul advised them not to continue. He said, this is not a very good idea to go any further. He knew that the seasons were really, really sad for a hurricane or tempest, as they called it. Paul them said, please don't go on. It was into the fall, and they continued to sail. They went against his advice and continued to sail. All of these events happened in Acts chapter 27. In verse 18, they were exceedingly tossed by a tempest. And you know, that must have been really a sad feeling out there in the middle of nowhere and being involved in a tempest of this magnitude. In verse number 20, it says, it got so bad they could no longer see the stars or the moon. And this says that they lost all hope that anyone could survive this tremendous storm that was going on. Folks, I want to tell you, all of us have storms in life of different things. It may be financial storm. It may be addiction storms within your family. It may be problems within yourself. It may be your finances. It may be your marriage. There's just a lot of storms that could come in life. But you know, friends, we can always trust God. If we're a Christian and we're saved, when we go through a storm, we can come through that storm victorious because we know that the Lord is with us. And they lost all hope. They could not even survive in verse 22. Paul told them also, he stood and said, be of good cheer. There's not going to be any loss of life tonight. In verse 23, Paul continues to say, for this night the angel of the God, whose I am and whom I serve, and fear not, for you must appear before Caesar. God has given all of these men on here that sail with you. You know, I like this particular verse about the angel when he says, of whose I am. He's describing the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the living word of God. He's described as I am. This was a mighty angel, I believe, with all of my heart, that was appearing to Paul in this saying and said, fear not, I'm with you and I'll be with you through every storm. In verse 25, it says, wherefore, sirs, be of good cheer, for I believe God that even as I told you, and you know, I told you that we all encounter many storms in life, and I want to talk to you about three great anchors briefly. The first one I want to talk about is faith. You have to have faith in God when you get saved. And if you're not saved today, you need to be saved and give your heart to God. Confess your sins and pray and have faith in God that he hears and answers your prayer. You know, there's one thing that Jesus said he's concerned about is he'll have faith when he comes back to this earth. We have to have faith in our heart to be a born-again Christian. God gives every one of us a measure of faith. Believe God for miracles. Trust God today that God's going to bring you through a storm. And then the next one I want to mention is the Word of God. We've got the greatest book that I hold right here in my hand today. It is the Word of the Living God. It will lead you through every storm. It will build your faith. That's the thing that really builds your faith, is hearing the Word of God and believing with the Word of God. And then the last one I want to mention to you is prayer. This is the one we don't probably take advantage of like we need to, but prayer will change things. Prayer will make a difference in your life. Getting before God and calling out for your needs, He will take care of every need if you will just pray and seek Him. All of my cousins, I thank you for listening to this broadcast. For all my family, my son listens to the broadcast, and my granddaughter listens to the broadcast, and I appreciate all of you that are listening today, and may God richly bless you and help you through every storm in life. That is my prayer in Jesus' name.